children's book, which is called The 300 Foxes, written by Diana and illustrated by her daughter Claudia. I was so surprised about it that I read it and thought it was lovely, and I ordered 8 copies. So Philip died for my grandchildren and family. And so Diana decided that she was going to bring the copies. And this book is dedicated to Prince Sadruddin out of Khan, which already touched me very much. And so Diana delivered 8 copies to the offices, the old Prince offices in town. And she told me of her experiences during her remarkable career that involved working with Prince Sadruddin, and how she had spoken with him about a biography when he was alive. He had told her that he did not want a biography before he was 70 years old. So, I became involved with the Bellamy Foundation as a volunteer with the Earthworkers publication. I was at that time very involved with the country of Belize and visiting schools in and around Geneva to raise awareness to the rainforest and the program for Belize to save 500,000 acres of rainforest in that small and beautiful country. I often had the opportunity of speaking to schools, and after arranging a visit to Belize for the teacher, David Batten, and his family, I was invited to a role-playing debate with his class of 12-year-olds on the rainforest. They were dressed up for the event as indigenous peoples, environmentalists, miners, and dam builders. And a young man in a suit with a tie and a big briefcase who took out a piece of paper and said, "I'm from the World Bank and I've got a check." So that was the subject. A lot of talking was done and the decision was made, "No bank, we keep our rainforest pristine." The other guests were Barry Gilbert-Miguet, who is here in this room, and Mr. David Pitt, who sadly is no longer with us from the International Union of the Conservation of Nature, and several parents. The students then wanted a newspaper. Barry approached the prince, and David got behind his computer. And up went Earth Focus magazine, written by young people for young people of all ages. It became a glossy magazine, a big newspaper and a glossy magazine. And thanks to the understanding and support of the prince, was published in 36 issues shared worldwide. I had the honor of meeting the prince because of Earth Focus. As a child, I had seen his father at the coronation of Queen Elizabeth II and at Windsor Great Park when he came to the polo match with the Queen after the races at Ascot. He was an impressive figure you do not forget. I first met the prince in 1994 when I introduced Mr. Martin Gordon, who became the publisher for the Earth Focus magazine. From then on, I was always amazed at his great respect for the young. He said, "We must empower young people and help them to be heard." He supported our activities with Earth Focus. He was always enthusiastic. I remember an event in Geneva. The prince was there as the students were arriving. On seeing 5 young Africans, he immediately went up to them, shaking their hands and making them feel at ease. Then as he spoke to the group, he discovered there were several young Ismailis in the group, and the conversation turned to how difficult it was to be an Ismaili.